I have absolutely no idea the last time I manually installed a version of Proton GE. I know how to do it. If I need to do it, I can go and do so. I just don't because ProtonUp QT exists and, like, it does everything I need it to do. I can just go add a version. I can then find the version I want, download the version, and then we're good to go. I don't need to manually install it. And there are a bunch of similar tools in various different toolkits that all do pretty much the same job. If what you want to do is download a version of Proton GE, it doesn't really matter which one you use. A lot of developers like to take something that already exists and then re-implement it in various different toolkits to kind of learn how those toolkits work or just have something in the toolkit they prefer. And recently, one of these tools has been getting quite a bit of attention. That is ProtonPlus. And for the sake of this video, I'll be running it as a flat pack. But if you want to use something else like the AUR or Fedora Copper, or there's some stuff for NixOS and various other platforms, those are available as well. But the flat pack is the primary installation method. If you're anything like me, the very first thing you'll notice is the toolkit of the application. ProtonUp QT is obviously written in QT. This is GTK4 with the LibidWaiter library. I have made my case on LibidWaiter many times before. I am not a fan of the library. In this context, though, I think this is a relatively well-designed interface. There are some issues the dev is aware of, and they are working on improving, and we'll get to those as we get to them. I think what makes a lot of sense here is comparing installing a new version of Proton or whatever you want to install with ProtonUp QT. So in ProtonUp QT, from the home screen, we're not able to actually install anything. All we can do here is choose versions to go and remove. If we want to add a new version, we go to the Add Version button down here, and now we have the interface where we can pick what we want. We can choose different compatibility tools we may want to use, but in my case, it's normally going to be Proton, and let's say I wanted 924, for example, click on that, click on install, and then it's going to take a bit of time. There is a download bar down the bottom here, and then when that is done, it will then be downloaded. It is done. It is downloaded. Now, over in Proton Plus, it actually starts from a more sensible place in the interface. We don't have to go to another screen to install things. Installation and removal is in the same screen. So let's go and get rid of that 924 I just installed. Yes, I want to get rid of it. Now it's gone. If I want to go and add something like 10.1, download that. It's going to do the same thing. It's going to download it. It's going to extract it. And then it will be here. I'll cut back to when it's done because Australian internet. After far too long of a wait, which is not the fault of the application, that would be Australia. It is downloaded. I can then get rid of it. There we go. Also, along here, you can see patch notes for the different versions as well, which is neat to see. I don't ever check them. Usually, if I'm downloading a version of Proton GE, it's because somebody else said that version is good, or it's the newest version. But that is just Proton GE. That is not the only option we have here. We also have Proton Cache OS, Proton EM, Proton Sarek, Proton Sarek Async, Proton GE, RTSP, Proton TKG. All of these are just forks of Proton with various changes, various patches. I don't use any of them besides Proton GE. I know there are people that like some of the Cache OS stuff. I don't even know what these other ones are. I know about Proton TKG. These other ones in here, I'm sure somebody has a use for them, so it's nice that they are an option to download here. Oh, there's also Northstar Proton. That is also a version of Proton as well. There are things that are not Proton, though. We also have Lux Torpedo, Boxtron, Roberta, and Steam Tinker Launch. Now, some of these things are also available inside of ProtonUp QT as well, but it doesn't have all of the random forks of Proton that people use nowadays. It does have Proton Cache OS, which is nice to see, but it doesn't have any of these other random ones like Sarek, Sarek Async, and GE, RTSP, and EM. I think those are the ones it's missing. These four in the middle here. If for whatever reason, this is not a full comprehensive list and there is something you may want to include, the dev is open to suggestions as well. If you would like to suggest something, feel free to go and open an issue about it and they will consider adding it. And considering it's literally just, in most cases, downloading from GitHub, they'd probably just add it because it'll take like 10 minutes to add. Whilst I do really like this interface, it does have some problems. Notably, is the number of versions available. So it'll show a lot of recent versions, which is nice. And for most cases, this is all you're going to need. But if for some reason you need a really old version, you gotta keep clicking load more and load more and load more and load more, and eventually you'll get to whatever version you want to see. This could be pretty easily resolved by adding a search bar. You don't even have to load everything by default, just add a search bar, and if they search for something old, load it then. If I was going to put it somewhere, I would put it literally right here. Just add a little search box and let them search whatever they want to search for and have it integrate with all of the options here. So if they want to search for some really old version and then we see the GE version, the cache version, all the sort of stuff, yeah, that would be good to see. Most cases, you don't need older versions, but there are some weird edge cases where there was a regression and some older game for some reason only works in a really weird old version. I don't run into this anywhere near as much anymore, but I know this has been a problem in the past. Just having the option is nice to have. Now, a problem you might be thinking is, okay, what if I were to install a version, say, I don't know, say you installed 7.26 at some point, and that's still on your system. If you wanted to get rid of that, you'd have to load a bunch of versions to be able to get down to the point where you can actually see the delete button. You don't have to do that. It is not immediately obvious, but if we go to the hamburger menu here, there is the installed only option, and it will just show you what you have. Now, don't be confused by this UI element. This is not a radio button at all. I guess you could call it a checkbox. But I think it's more apt to call, because there's only like one option in the list. I think it's more apt to call it like a binary toggle styled as a radio button, which, please don't do this for the record. This is not what that UI element means. Also, I know someone's going to say it. I agree. It is dumb that this is in a hamburger menu and there is one button in the hamburger menu. The keyboard shortcuts doesn't actually have any keyboard shortcuts, so this button is literally useless, and about, it doesn't need to be there either. So the menu could be deleted and the button put right in the bar. And this is something the dev is aware of and is willing to go and change. For the about section, there is literally already a donate button, so that donate button could be repurposed to also be the about as well. There doesn't need to be a dedicated button there. Anyway, so far I've just been showing you Steam, and in the top left corner here, there is a Steam button. This gives you a drop down of other launchers you have installed on your system. For me, that is just Lutris on my system and Lutris as a flat pack. I don't know why I have them both installed. I must have been testing something at some point, but those are not the only options available. If we do go click on Lutris though, there are going to be different things we can get. We can download versions of Wine, we can download versions of DXVK, VKD3D, and there you go. Also, there are other things you can download as well. There are other launchers that are supported. Right now, that is the Heroic Games launcher, Bottles, and Wine Z GUI. If, again, there is something else you would like to see supported, the dev is open to adding support for those as well. Of course, adding a new launcher is going to be a bit more complex than just adding in new things to download from GitHub, so that will take quite a bit more time and some justification for why that thing should be supported. But I would say this list is most of the things that people do care about. So far, I've just been showing you the Runners tab. There is another one here, the Games tab. Lutris currently is unsupported here, so you're not able to actually do anything here. Over in ProtonUp QT, if we go over to the application is frozen. Let me restart that. Moving on from that. If we go over to Lutris and I go to show game list, There is also support for that over here as well. I don't actually use Lucha so much. There's just an Obacula drop in here. Also, for Steam, there is that option as well. Now, if we go to Proton Plus, I go back to Steam. This is actually supported. In this, we can go and configure stuff. If for some reason you don't see a list of your Steam games here, open up Steam and then they should be listed here. I did run into that problem once. I don't know why that happens. Steam is weird. Anyway, from here, we can go and configure what versions we want to be using. So, for example, I'm playing Final Fantasy VII right now. If I want to go change that over to Proton Experimental or Proton 10.0 Beta, I can do that directly in this interface. I don't have to do it in Steam. And that's not all we can do. We can also modify the game launch options. Right now, I'm not actually using any. If we go to Marvel Rivals, this one does have a bunch because Marvel Rivals, weird buggy game. And if you don't just want to modify one thing, you can also select everything as well and do a mass edit. Now, I am not going to do that because I don't want to go and change the compatibility tool for literally everything. But it is something you can do. So I'm going to go and unselect it. And if you want to go set a default, which is the way that I typically go and do things, right now that is set to Proton Experimental, but if I want my default to be 10.9, it's now 10.9. Obviously, you have to apply it first, and there you go. And verifying that over in Steam, Proton GE 10.9. Now, if you make a change in Steam, and you notice that it doesn't actually show anything. You notice that it didn't actually listen to your settings. That's because Steam is weird and you have to close Steam every time you download a new version, every time you modify it with this. That's a problem with Proton Opportunity as well. That's just how Steam works. I don't know why Steam works like that. Go and ask Valve about it. We also have a button to go directly to the ProtonDB page. So if you want to go and actually see what you might need to set, hey, that's there as well. And lastly, we have this little three dots here to open up the install directory and open up the prefix directory, which are things I never personally go and deal with. But if there's something you need to go and maybe, I don't know, copy a save file or install mods, things like that, that's a way to get directly to those locations. And you can do those things in ProtonOpQt as well. It's just not the prettiest of interfaces. It works. It works. It's very clear that what we have here is starting out as basically a libid way to version of ProtonOpQt. And that's not a bad thing because it takes the idea of the way this application works and, in my opinion, actually improves upon it. But that does not mean that is going to be the end. That is going to be where it stops. There is a bunch of changes the dev still wants to go and make. One of those is a periodic update checker. I'm personally not a big fan of doing that. I hope it's something you can disable. But if you're someone who always wants to have the latest version of Proton GE or the latest version of TKG or whatever other thing you might be using, having it there as an option to just go and download it for you, very nice to see. Add controller support. This is an application which makes a lot of sense in contexts like the Steam Deck, and having a nice way to navigate around that without having to use the touchpads is cool to see. Add a theme for the Steam Deck users alongside that one as well. Add command line support. So there used to be a tool called Proton Up, and it still works, but it hasn't been updated in a very long time. I don't know if it's always going to work. They might change where things are stored and end up breaking things, or maybe the location of where Proton GE is stored, things like that. Also, there are other clients that you might want to support which are not supported in Proton Up. Having a command line interface for this is very nice to see, and for people who like scripting, awesome to have. Add a simple mod manager. I've gotten used to just installing mods manually on Linux because a lot of the mod managers people use on Windows don't have Linux support. There are projects in the works for that, but a lot of them are still fairly early on. So having more in this space, my opinion, really nice to see. And prefix management. So if you want to go and modify exactly how the prefix works and install dependencies and things like that, That's also really cool. But if you're like me and literally all you do is download new versions of Proton GE, honestly, either of these tools are fine. I use ProtonUpQT because I just open it and then immediately close it. Maybe I'll try this out though. But if you're someone who wants more from this tool, honestly, I would give this one a shot and see where it goes. But let me know your thoughts down below. Do you use this already? Do you use ProtonUpQT? Do you just download things manually? Do you even know what Proton is? I would like to know. If you liked the video, go like the video and be sure to subscribe as well. If you really like the video and you want to become one of these amazing people over here, check out the Patreon, subscribe to Liberapay, link in the description down below. That's going to be it for me and video games. Like this.